hello again. You're now watching the third video on ASPICE assessments. This video is about preparing for an ASPICE assessment. I am Juan Webb, and I am a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. The results of an assessment is of great importance to your project. You gain valuable insight into how you can improve your workflows to reduce your risks. So it's a bad idea to falsify evidence for the sake of the assessment. In the long run, you will be taking risk if you decide to put lipstick on a pig. So think of assessment as an opportunity, as a position finding exercise that will provide some useful insights. However, part of the right attitude is that you prepare yourself thoroughly. For this is the only way to familiarize yourself again with the tasks and processes that have been in the past for a long time. There is a lot of time and pressure in the assessment itself, but thorough preparation allows you to answer clearly and precisely. In this way, you are controlling the assessment to a certain extent. You can also practice the terminology of ASPICE again. In this way, you know immediately what the assessor expects when he or she is specifically asking about a work product. In this video, I show you what to expect during the assessment. We can discuss an ideal preparation in three phases. You know, well in advance of the assessment, shortly before the assessment, and during the assessment. So, number one, how do you prepare for an assessment 2 to 3 months in advance? In my last video, I presented a diagram of the regular assessment process. Within it, there are three phases. On the left-hand side, you see the preparation phase. Let's have a look at this phase. Finalize the assessment agenda in time. This is a prerequisite to identify the right people as interviewees. Understand the status quo of the project regarding ASPICE. Consider which areas in the project are crucial or which team has particular struggles with it. Map ASPICE practices to real-life implementation in your project. See if it fits. When not, identify remaining gaps between formal expectation and your implementation. Then create an improvement plan for how you will close those gaps. Now, I think you've gotten the idea of what a good preparation comes down to. So deal intensively with what you and your team have accomplished. With this, you can make up for minor omissions. Remember, no one is perfect. So in this way, you remain honest without being unprepared during the assessment. So let's continue with the second phase, preparation about 2 to 3 weeks before the assessment date. So in our diagram, we're still in the preparation phase. So in a first step, we would like to clean up the project folder. We ensure that there are no issues with the naming and versioning of documents. Remove artifacts that are not relevant anymore. Make sure all teammates know where to find all the important documents. Prepare select work products to present as evidence. And ensure that the interviewees understand the requirements of ASPICE. If they need a little coaching, I recommend our short video, Automotive SPICE Oversimplified. Teach them what their role is in the assessment should be. Brief them on how to explain the ways in which their tasks contribute to in meeting the ASPICE requirements. And the last point is on soft skills. Coach your teammates and stakeholders in your company intensively on how they should behave in an interview situation. If you keep this list in mind, you will see how the important intensive preparation is. You don't want to do anything wrong, but you also don't need to sell your performance short. Now, the third point is about said soft skills. How do my teammates best behave during an assessment? The best preparation for an interviewee is to become familiar with the content of the processes relevant to him or her. Do your teammates know the relevant processes, descriptions, and process steps? Do they know the generic practices? The GPs address such aspects of capability level 2 and 3 as skill management or resource management. What about the project binder structure? Do your teammates understand the overall structure? Do they know where the work products are stored? Do they find them quickly and easily? Do they know which work products and selected samples you would like to present? Consider a work product list as part of your preparation. Do you speak ASPICE? Do you and your teammates know the essential terms of the standard? Do you understand these as well as the underlying logic of ASPICE? So read the base practices and generic practices of all of your related processes. So this briefing is essential. This is because interviewees are often unaware of how their work and performance fits into the model. And as a result, ratings can be worse than they should be. Avoid this trap by preparing thoroughly for the interview. Do you have an answer ready for possible closing question? What are the topics that have not yet been addressed by the assessor? What is particularly good? What things are you proud of within your project? Convey a positive attitude to your teammates. How should they go into the assessment? For this purpose, I will present to you a few do's and don'ts. So, avoid long PowerPoint presentations about how processes should work. These are not the evidence your assessor is looking for. Instead, show authentic documentation. Answer questions directly. Do not tell long stories. Don't bring up additional topics without a reason. Of course, you can talk in detail about strengths of the project or bring topics into the conversation that you are well prepared for. Act as a team. Don't blame others or say, "This is not my responsibility." Instead, say, "Please ask Mrs. X. She could answer the question." You should have a positive example ready for your area of responsibility. With this sample, you can document how the requirements were lived and implemented in the project. If a process weakness becomes obvious, don't try to cover it up. Instead, tell what you've done to compensate for the weakness. Show your improvement plan to demonstrate that the weakness has already been identified and an action plan is in place. Of course, to be able to do this, you need to invest in the assessment preparation early. The timeliness of documents is often checked during an assessment using timestamps and document history. If documents were created in preparation for the assessment, don't hide this fact. For example, a cost estimate is due at the beginning of the project, not in the second year of the project. If the assessor feels that you're trying to deceive them, the assessment usually becomes unpleasant as the assessor loses confidence. Repeat the mantra often so that your teammates internalize it. The assessor evaluates processes, not people. Assessment preparation is like everything else in life. Without preparation, many things are nothing. Take the preparation seriously. If your processes show too many weaknesses, you may feel the displeasure of your customer, and you'll definitely have more trouble eliminating the weaknesses than you will have to invest in the preparation. In this video, I showed you how you and your team should prepare thoroughly for an assessment, well in advance of the actual assessment date. Invest the time to get it right the first time. Now, this is my advice for great preparation. If you liked my video, please subscribe to our Kuglemag YouTube channel. Then you won't miss the next one. Stay tuned and see you soon.
Kuglemag and Company is engineering made smart.